hopelessness, apathy, self-loathing, living in a black hole. These emotions are a fact of life for at least 3 million Filipinos currently suffering from some form of depressive disorder, an overwhelming number considering the country reportedly only has 5,000 psychiatrists and psychologists who can come to their aid. It's a problem-turned-opportunity for business and life partners Loren Consul and Edward Torres, who founded mental health platform Listen Here.
I'm a licensed therapist in the U.S., and so I have almost a decade of experience in the mental health field.
I have a lifelong passion with wellness and total well-being.
We moved to the Philippines just relatively shortly after the mental health law passed, and when we started to talk to people and really get the idea of what the current state of mental health is here in the Philippines, we realized there were some serious gaps in services and offerings. In the U.S. right now, mental health is very trendy. You talk to people here, it's like the thing when you ask them, like, who do you turn to for support and help? You know, the people that they say they aren't going to turn to is either family.
Listen Here provides affordable and accessible in-person and online therapy, both through its community-centered initiatives and its upcoming mobile application, which would match clients with on-call licensed therapists.
The first part you'll see is they'll be notified when their appointment will be. If they see a support group happening in their area, they'll know that they can meet their friends. And we'd like to potentially see something like a daily check-in, something that could help them track their moods. Maybe on certain days of the week, they feel certain ways, and once they start seeing patterns.
Lots of my clients actually enjoyed the online platform because anywhere they were in the globe at any time, we could easily talk about our appointment.
For the psychologist, it also makes you a bit more aware of other nonverbals that you may not necessarily always be attuned to in one-on-one counseling or in-person counseling and therapy. For example, one thing that I've noticed is I started to take note of maybe how long a person will pause before they talk, maybe the depth of the breath that the person might have before saying something.
And here's the thing, you don't even have to suffer from mental illness to access talk therapy. Loren says even those who actually feel good but want to understand themselves better are equally welcome to avail of their services.
Mental health really is a spectrum, and we can fall anywhere on this spectrum. You know, there's going to be daily stresses in life, and really how we cope with those is how kind of a barometer of our mental health right now. So really anyone can benefit from virtual therapy, from, you know, engaging with a therapist. You don't have to have a mental illness, you don't have to be depressed or anxious. It can even be when you're like, I think something's just not right, I'm just not feeling good.
Listen Here targets to have every licensed psychologist on board until talking about mental health is no longer a difficult discussion.
It starts with me and you. It starts with us just asking each other how we're doing, being present, being mindful. And from there, then we can start talking about deeper issues, right? If we find that the number of psychologists has increased, talking about mental health issues is normalized to a point where people are just day-to-day talking to each other, talking to their family members. If we can quantify that with research, not just virtual therapy, but just any therapy, then we would have done our job.
And that's another inspiring story on Think Possible. If you know of another problem solver or simply a good Samaritan changing the world one deed at a time, send us an email at ancthinkpossible@gmail.com. For more positive stories on your feed, make sure to like and follow us on Facebook and subscribe to our YouTube channel. We'd love to hear from you.